Hey, you know, everybody's talking about the good old days, right?
Yeah.
Everybody, the good old days, the good old days.
Good old days.
Well, let's talk about the good old days.
Let's talk about them shit, man. Hold up, baby.
Hi, I'm Stan Lee, and I have a big treat for you, and I know it's going to be a big treat for me. I'm here with one of the top talents in the comic book business, Jim Lee.
Jim, it's great to see you.
How do you do, Sam?
Listen, you know, the old gag about our parents are the only ones who can tell us apart, right? My namesake over here,
right.
And I'm proud of it. This is really such an incredible fact, it's hard to believe. Years ago, and over the years in the comic book business, if a book sold 500,000 copies, or 750,000, or 1,000,000 copies for a comic book, I mean, that was phenomenal. Well, this man, Jim Lee, did the highest selling, illustrated the highest selling comic book of all time last year. He did Xmen number one, and Jim, I can't even tell him how many copies that book sold.
I think we sold about 8.2 million copies. So yeah. That was the latest count.
8.2 million copies of one comic book, and Jim, you've got to show the book.
Well, we're still counting the results from Idaho and stuff. We got a lot of regular buyers. This is three of the five covers. I guess the other two are sold out. But they're all X-Men number one. They're all released in August of 1991.
Even Jim can't get them all. Now, I think you better explain what you mean by three. You know, usually you do a comic book and it has one cover.
Right.
What happened over here?
Well, basically, recent history has shown that when they produce a number one comic, especially of a popular title like Spider-Man or X-Men, there's a very strong response from the audience, the collectors and the readers. They'll buy multiple copies because they like it so much and they see it as an investment.